Hi, I'm Jonathan Valdez from orangejuiceandbiscuits.com, and you're at the Tweetheart Tweetup at the Mandarin Oriental's Mo Bar during Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week Fall 2012.
Okay, so Jonathan, I recently just heard that you are now writing for the Fashion Police. That's really exciting. Can you tell us more about that?
I started working with Us Weekly as a top cop for their Fashion Week section, which is the fun section in the back that everyone likes to read and see, like, who looked a mess or worked their dress, as I like to say. So yeah, actually that came about through Twitter. The fashion director followed me and we were just talking back and forth, and I kind of told her I was interested, and, you know, long story short, I was very lucky to be able to have the opportunity to do that.
So you're saying that Twitter, for all those people out there who don't believe in Twitter, that Twitter actually helped you get a position with Us Weekly?
Yes.
So tell me how you think Twitter can help bloggers and people in the fashion industry with their business.
Yeah, I think that it's a very essential and vital tool. I mean, honestly, Twitter is the reason I'm in New York City, because I started networking as I was graduating and connecting with people and seeing what was really going on in New York. And I think it's just really important to use it correctly and to take it from offline onto online and develop relationships with people and then meet them in person. But it's also treat it like a real relationship, you know, take time to get to know what they're really interested in and how you can maybe work together, and then turn that into a real life meeting. And I've done that numerous times and I just can't say enough about it.
Can you give me an idea of, like, how much time should a person with a fashion business spend on Twitter a day to help develop those relationships?
You know, I think, you know, for a brand, I think it's important to use a tool like Hootsuite and just set up things throughout the day. Like,
we do that.
I would say about, you know, 10 tweets, you know, would be appropriate. If you're really wanting something to engage in your audience, then it would be a great idea to set a budget for a social media person. That way they can interact throughout the day, because the number one thing on Twitter is people like to be responded to. They like to feel like they're being heard. So if that brand is talking to you, you know, they get excited and then they'll go out and be like, oh, I saw your ad campaign. And then you tweet them and it just keeps going and it's wonderful.
So how long have you had your Twitter account?
I've had mine since 2009, and it's funny because...
So you're an early adopter.
Yes. Well, my friend had to tell me to do it because, you know, I was like, oh, I don't know, that's kind of silly, but I learned it is so vital, and it's grown and changed so much, and it really is what you do with it, because, you know, some people say, oh, it's silly, no one wants to know what I had for breakfast. Well, that's not what we're using it for, as you know.
Right.
You know, we're using it to build our brands, and it's a powerful tool. You know, using something like Fashion Week, or if it's South by Southwest, or it's an auto show, like, whatever you're talking about, you really need to find that content, and those people will find you and stick with you.
Okay, so give me your top three do's for growing your business using Twitter.
Be selective about, you know, who you're interacting with on Twitter, because it's just like what they say, you know, you are who you keep your company with. But then at the same time, I don't agree with the, you know, oh, I can only follow this many people or that many people. That's part of what makes you popular, is if you're that person in that field that speaks to everyone. I've seen so many brands that are kind of subpar brands but they interact with people and they retweet them all the time. And so people have made them very popular recently. Do watch what you say. Like I said, don't be negative. Don't talk about people. Just stick with what you want, like what you're speaking with. Keep it positive. People really want to see positivity. Be your own voice. I mean, don't try to do what other people are doing, because, you know, it's kind of like a mall. There's something for everyone, and you want to be yourself, and you'd be amazed how many people really respond to that.
So you're here at New York Fashion Week. So tell us what it's like to attend shows and tweet from the runway.
Attending shows is amazing, especially when you get that show that maybe you didn't get last season. And it's just really exciting to, you know, tweet those tweets out to the people who look to you for the inside information. And I love it. And just seeing people say, thank you so much for, like, taking me inside the tents, that really means a lot, because I know what it's like to have lived in Texas and be like, I really wish I was in the tent. So it's a wonderful feeling that when people take the time to reach out and then thank you just for doing what you love. It's a nice feeling.